Hi there, needing a hand to remove a blank or extra page in Word? Let me help. Hey, I'm Sharyn from Excel at Work, where we offer straightforward, non-technical assistance to help you save time, work smarter, and improve your skills in office applications. If you're new here and you love helpful tips and guidance, please click that subscribe button. Oh, and to speed things up, I've popped jump links to each of the topics I cover in this video in the description box below. So, let's talk about removing a page break. If you're watching this, you're probably wrestling with an extra page break or a blank page or a lot of space within your document somewhere. I'm going to show you several different fixes, starting with the easiest and moving to the more unusual fixes. So let's get going and see if I can help you out. Right, let's see if we can fix this extra page that's in your document. So fix number one that I want to go through with you, you'll need to do this. On the Home tab, you would need to come over here and click on the Show Hide Character. Now, once that's on, you're going to see a little symbol on your screen, and that represents wherever the Enter key has been hit on the keyboard to start a new paragraph. Now, I'm just going to go over to the View tab, and I'm going to use the side-to-side view so that you can see what I'm doing. So this is page one, this is page two, and you can see a whole heap of little symbols. Now that means that somebody has just done this. They've popped their insertion point at a point on the page and pressed enter a lot of times. So if you've got an extra page with all of these symbols in them, what I would suggest you do is you highlight over them and press your delete key. And you can see that you're now starting to bring your paragraphs together. So if you can see them and they're not wanted, just delete them out and you will bring your paragraphs back together again. So that's fix number one. Right, fix number two. When you have your show hide characters turned on, you can also see wherever a page break has been inserted into the document. So creating a page break is really simple. You can place your insertion point wherever you want to start information on a new page, or say for example, I wanted this paragraph to start on a new page, and on the insert tab, I can pop a page break in. And as you do that, you will create a page break symbol. So all you need to do is remove the symbol and you will see that you will actually bring your text back together again. So at any time you can do that. You can just take out the page break and there you go. You're actually getting rid of those extra pages. Right, fix number three. I'm just going to come forward a little bit into the document. Here we've got a heading, but we've got a big gap underneath it. And there are no paragraph markers to show that anybody's hit the enter key to actually create this space. Also, you'll notice that there's no page break symbol either underneath here. So how come this information is starting on a new page? Why is there this gap? So I want to show you this. I'm just going to come over to this paragraph over here. And I want to point out, I don't know how well you can see this actually, but there is a tiny wee little square just to the left of the W there. Right, I'm going over to the Home tab. I'm going to make my way to Paragraph and click on the Paragraph dialog box launcher. Now you can also get there just by doing a right click over the paragraph and left clicking paragraph as well. Right, once you're in here, line and page breaks is where I need you to go. And I want to show you this. I'm just going to come bring this down here. This paragraph has a setting on it to say page break before. So if you've got this kind of look and you're thinking, why on earth have I got such a big gap? Why have I got a blank page? I can't see why it's happening. Remove this. Click on OK. And look, you'll bring them back together again. So I'm really hoping that one of those tips has fixed your problem so far. But if it hasn't, let's talk about this last tip. Okay, we're going to talk about section breaks, but before I even get you to remove the section break, I want to point this out. If I just go back in my document, you'll see that there's page numbering on a couple of these pages. So page two, page three, the last page doesn't have it. So when we have section breaks in a document, it means that there's document formatting that's been changed somewhere in the document. If I click up into here, and I just want to take you down to where my mouse is, you can see it says section one down in the left corner of the page. So that's one section of the document that has page numbering on it. Now, if I come over here and click onto this page, we're now on section two and it doesn't have page numbering on it. So watch what happens when you delete the section breakout. You will definitely remove the page break. So obviously if you've got blank pages that have been created by section breaks, it will actually remove that blank page for you. However, what it'll also do is it'll take the settings for that section and apply it to the section before. So it's taking the formattings or the page formattings from section two and applying them to now section one. So see how the page numbering's gone? So be very careful when you're deleting section breaks, okay? And just maybe have a look at all the different things that are going on in the document. It could be headers and footers, could be page numbering, it could even be portrait to landscape. Yes, it will obviously help you with removing the blank pages, but just keep an eye out for that. So if the section break is what's causing the blank page in your document or the gap in your document, and you're a little bit concerned about removing headers, footers, page numbers and things like that, in fact, what I'll do is I'll just undo this so that we get our page numbers back. I'll just show you this. If we come through to the appendix page here, I'm just going to double click down into the bottom of section two. Now, up the very top here, I can go link to previous. I'm just going to go ahead and do that. And it'll just say, do you want to delete this header and footer and connect to the previous one? If I say yes, you can see now it's actually pulled through the page numbering. So if I now come out of here and delete that section break, you will see that the page numbering stays on. So that might be a way that you can delete that page break, but still keep the headers and footers from your previous section. Hey, and the last thing I want to cover is when you have a rogue last page, that last page you just can't get rid of. And if everything I've shown you so far hasn't worked, watch this. I'm just going to come over here, pop in a page break. And we've got this paragraph marker on the last page. And of course, I've been saying to you, just highlight it, press delete, and nothing happens. It doesn't disappear. But can you see on the previous page, there is a page break here. So all you need to do is go to the previous page and make sure that you highlight the page break, press your delete key, and there you go. That rogue page will be gone. So I really hope that one of these tips has sorted your problem and you are now able to get rid of those pesky page breaks in Word. If this has been helpful, please hit the like button and please let me know in the comments below which one of these fixes actually helped you out. And if you'd like to stay connected, please make sure that you subscribe and hit the bell because I'm creating and sharing new videos regularly. And if you know of anyone that this could help as well, please be sure to share this video with them. Hey, thanks for watching and have a fabulous day.